bless you. Welcome to Couples Forum. We bless the holy name of God. The God we are serving is a mighty God.
Hallelujah.
And he's going to begin to work his wonders and miracles even in your lives and destinies. In the name of Jesus, we are so glad you're able to join with us on this program, Couples Forum. Thank God we are back. After a long break, it is well with your soul. And thank you for joining with us. God bless you. My name is Chris, Pastor Chris of Body of Christ Center. I'm here with my wife, Pastor Funke.
God bless you. You are blessed and highly favored. Happy Sunday. Good evening. God bless you. Thank you so much for joining this broadcast. You are blessed and highly favored in Jesus' name.
We're believing that God will do a great thing and mighty thing in every life and destiny. In Jesus, you're going to arise and shine, prosper and succeed mightily and marvelously in the name of Jesus. You watching is not by accident, it is by divine appointment.
Hallelujah.
And we know that the Lord will begin to work his great wonders and miracles even in your lives and destiny. So welcome to another edition of Couples Forum. Hashtag happy couple. So we thank God and bless God for his goodness and mercies in our lives in Jesus' name.
Amen. God bless everyone out there. You are blessed and highly favored. Thank you for joining us. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Please, as you are joining, invite somebody and God will bless us all, even like never before, in Jesus' name.
As you know, we are on two platforms. We are on Facebook. That is our Facebook address. So everybody, please send out a reminder and let your people know that Couples Forum is on right now on this Facebook page, and God will bless, increase, and prosper you mightily and marvelously. So share on your page, share on your timeline, share within the groups you belong to, and share into relationship or married groups. You know, that's very, very important. Let's share into such groups, and God will bless you, because what we discuss, you know, is interactive. Everybody will gain and be blessed. As we are blessed, you are blessed. So we are all blessed. Iron sharpened iron.
Hallelujah.
Is action and reaction are equal and opposite. So we are getting from you, you are getting from us, and God will bless. And we are also on YouTube. That is our YouTube channel, as you can see on the screen. Those who are YouTubers, please share or let your subscribers know, and God will bless you. And also share on every social media platform you are on, and God will bless, increase, and prosper. Welcome to Couples Forum. You are blessed.
Yeah, welcome to Couples Forum. God bless you. It's good to see everyone out there on.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Please invite somebody. Tell them this program is on. And Jehovah God will bless everybody. Thank you so much. Happy Sunday once again. Thank you so much. You are lifted.
For those who have shared, thank you. Please keep on sharing, sharing, sharing. Invite your... Now, if you are watching alone and your spouse is within, is with you in your house, take the device up to him or her, or call him or her down where you are, and begin to watch together. You can cast it on your screen, on your TV, and then you can make comments through your little device. You understand? So you are watching together, your husband, your wife, you are watching together, and also making comments, because the good thing about this program is your comments. Your comments are very, very important, and God will bless everyone mightily. So you are welcome to Couples Forum. God will bless, increase, and prosper you. Let's get sharing. Let's get calling. Let's invite all of our friends, and God will bless you all in Jesus' name.
Amen. Happy Sunday to everyone out there. God bless you. Please keep inviting somebody. Don't be tired of inviting them. Just send them the link, and God will bless us all in Jesus' name. You are welcome to this program, and Jehovah God will bless every life, even like never before, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you. Let's glorify you. We give you all the praise, glory, honor. Thank you, Lord, for the first Sunday in the 11th month of this year. We bless and worship and adore you. Thank you for thoughts for you have helped us even on this live program.
My Couples
Forum, I accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This is your doing, Lord, and it's marvelous in our eyes, in our sight. We bless and worship and praise and adore you. I accept our thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And Father, every sin, Lord, forgive in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Cleanse us with your blood. Holy Ghost, gather with us.
Amen.
It is you that instituted marriage. It was you that said it's not good for man to be alone.
Amen.
You make a helpmate for him. And Father, gather with us. Have your way. Prove yourself. Do a new work. We come against every disturbing spirit, every distracted spirit, every spirit of quarreling. We bind, we cast to hell in the name of Jesus. Let your peace reign and your name be glorified.
Amen.
We declare peace over every marriage, over every relationship, over every man and woman. Mighty Father, we declare your peace in the hearts of everyone in Jesus' name. Those who are married, Mighty Father, we declare your peace in their midst in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let your name be glorified.
Amen.
Father, we honor and we bless you.
Amen.
In Jesus' precious and wonderful name we pray.
Amen. Once again, you are welcome to Couples Forum. God bless you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for joining us this hour. You know God will touch every life. Please, as you are joining, invite somebody and God will bless us all, even like never before, in Jesus' name.
And don't forget, those who are joining us are new, we air this program every Sunday, Sunday at 8 p.m. That's UK time. Every Sunday at 8 p.m. Once again, you are all welcome. Please, importantly, keep on sharing. You can text, you can SMS, you can WhatsApp, you can, you have many devices now, you can WhatsApp, you can Instagram, you can tweet, you can do all these things, you can send reminders each individually to you can share on Facebook. So we have different platforms and different forums whereby we can send this program, send this link. Those who are still using Periscope, you can Periscope it, if I use that word.
So if,
you can,
if anybody is still using that.
Some people are using it. You can Instagram it, you can do anything. So let's get sharing, let's get people. And the beauty of it is that the only way we can see that you are with us is if you make a comment, yes, either on Facebook or YouTube. You can pick up your comments on both platforms. So whether you are on Facebook, whether you are on YouTube, stay where you are and enjoy. Don't flick up or down. Stay on this channel, stay on this program, and you'll be blessed in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Welcome once again. God bless you. Thank you so much. We know the God of heaven will touch every life, and there shall be, and we'll enjoy this program even like never before, in Jesus' name.
Amen, 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 amen. So, welcome to Married Couples Forum. Mm. This is a forum where we talk about how to stay together in love, in peace, and in harmony. In the beginning, the Bible says, in the book of Genesis 2:18, the Lord God also said, it is not good for man to be alone. I will make for him a suitable helper. That's why God created Eve in Genesis chapter 2:22, and from the rib, that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made a woman and brought her to him.
Hallelujah. So married couples are two hearts that beat as one.
Yes.
Are you one with your spouse? In Genesis 2:24, the Bible says, for this reason a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh.
And we have some mottos we already discussed. Some of our mottos is the first one is staying together in love, peace, and harmony. It's very important for couples to stay together in love, yes, in peace, and harmony. Mm. That is very, very important. You know, the Bible said that enjoy your life with the wife of your youth. Mm. So if you're a man out there, enjoy your life with your wife. If you're a woman out there,
enjoy your life with your husband.
It's not used quarreling and quarreling. Mm-hmm. Every time your face is hard, every time you're complaining, every time you're moaning, every time you're out of the door, every time you're annoyed, every time you're not eating, every time you are annoyed, every time you are always moaning and complaining. Let us stop. Somebody says, stop that. It's time for us to stop. Why? Because this year is going to an end again. God forbid, do you want to be the same in 2022? I know it's no. Mm-hmm. No, by God's grace. So, change. Somebody say, change. We need to change. As a man there, you need to change.
As a woman there, you need to change.
So, you need to stay together in love, in peace, and harmony. Enough of this bickering. Enough of this mourning. Enough of this complaining. Enough of this pointing fingers. Let us live together in love, and in peace, and in harmony, and God would help us in the name of the first love you had for your darling. The first love. Rekindle that first love and see what God would do.
Yes, and actually, if you are always quarreling, always fighting, how can you even enjoy your own
that
life?
That is true. That is it.
No, it's true. Somebody's always quarreling, always fighting. If they're not careful, they will have ill health.
Of course.
May we not have ill health in Jesus' name. I'm telling you, don't allow anything to hold you in captivity.
Yes,
enjoy your life.
Enjoy
your relationship. At least you're in the relationship.
Of course.
You know you are not going anywhere. Why not just make up and say, you know what? I'm enjoying this relationship. Whether the devil likes it, make up your mind. That's why it says, stand together in love, peace, and harmony.
Yes,
and the other one says, two hearts that beat as one. Beloved, is your heart beating as one with your spouse? You know what? That is, marriage is a partnership, it's a teamwork, it's collaboration. That is, the two of you will come together, you work as a team.
Yes,
and that is where there is result. So we are begging you. In the name of the Lord.
Pleading with you.
We are pleading with you.
Admonishing you.
We are advising you. We are encouraging you.
Correcting you.
Please. Be at peace. Enjoy your life. Because I can imagine somebody's always quarreling. They are waking up, they are angry. Going to bed,
they are angry.
Whether husband or wife. How can the person enjoy life? I'm begging you. Please, we are begging you. Enjoy your life. You are in the marriage, you are not going anywhere. Especially when you are born again, you know you are not going anywhere. You better choose to just, say, you know what? I'm going to enjoy my life to the fullest.
Of course, so enjoy your marriage with the wife of your youth. enjoy your marriage with the husband. If I use that word, with the husband of your youth. Mm. Marriage is supposed to be enjoyed. Marriage is not someone overriding the other. It's not someone taking advantage of the other. Marriage is the two shall become one. Mm. So they share things equally.
It's not about controlling.
It's not about controlling. You do things equally, you share ideas equally, and you come to an agreement equally. That's all what marriage is about. It's supposed to be about. We know in practical sense, sometimes you have to adjust. Yes, but that is all what marriage should be about. That's working together as a team. Teamwork is very important.
Yeah.
Teamwork is very important. Mm-hmm. Teamwork is that together, each of us, we achieve more. Together, we achieve more. That's teamwork. Together, everybody achieves more. So together, you and your husband, you and your wife, you would achieve more. So you want to achieve more, because you know this year is going to an end again.
Yes.
Can you believe, Pastor? We are in November.
Yes.
We are in November.
Yes.
And before we know it now, December will come. We'll shout a happy new year. So change your attitude, change your touch, change your thinking process, change your mindset, and enjoy life with your wife.
Mm.
Enjoy life with your husband. Enjoy life with your spouse. Because that is the sole purpose of, at least if I can say, living. Because you are married, you are married. So you are in it. You are in it. As people say, you are in it already. So there's no way.
Mm.
So you better make up your mind to begin to enjoy with your spouse.
Like when you were talking, what is going through my mind is, your spouse is not your steering wheel.
Mm.
You steer her that way.
Or you steer him.
You steer him that way.
Mm.
It doesn't work like that.
It doesn't work well.
Work in harmony.
Mm.
Work together.
Mm.
Choose, especially if you are Christians.
Of course. So.
If you are a Christian and you are not enjoying your marriage, then what about unbelievers?
Of
then
course so.
You are born again. You are giving your life to Jesus. And in case you are not born again now, then it's good to be born again.
Of course.
But for the fact that you are born again, it's no reason for you, and you'll be shocked how many homes are somehow
at loggerheads.
Even though they are born again, it shouldn't be like that.
Mm.
Like what Pastor Chichi said, she said, it is an understanding.
Mm.
It is overlooking.
That is it.
It is letting go. It is simply loving like Christ loves.
That is it, too.
Are you loving as Christ loves? That is, do you have the mind of Christ?
Mm.
Because honestly, it's true. And you'll be surprised. People are getting old. They are still quarreling. They are still fighting. They are still behaving like cat and rat.
Mm.
Somebody said it has to stop. It's a new day. It's a new season. If you are still quarreling, you are the only one left as a born again child of God. You are the only one left in that school. Everybody has moved on. Hallelujah. Amen.
So let your hearts beat together with your spouse as one. Very important. Let me repeat that. Let your heart beat together with your spouse as one.
Mm.
Very important. Two hearts that beat as one. That's why God said the two shall become one.
Mm.
God does not see couple as one. He sees them. He doesn't see them as two. He sees them as one. One, 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 one. So be one with your spouse, be one with your husband, be one with your wife,
yes,
and God will work wonders in every life in Jesus' name.
Amen. Sister Christa says it's a new
season. Hallelujah. Do you know you can bring a new season into your marriage?
Yes.
Do you know you can
start?
Do you know you can make up your mind that as from this minute, today is the 7th of November, 2020. As from today, the 7th of November, I will bring peace. I will bring joy.
Mm-hmm.
I will bring happiness into my marriage.
True.
And my marriage will work, and I will make up my mind to continue to begin to enjoy my marriage.
Mm. And for adventure, maybe your husband is quarrelsome. Make up your mind. You know what? I'm not joining this party.
Yes,
sir. I'm not joining this party of quarreling.
Mm.
It's a new day in my life.
Mm.
You start it.
Mm.
Start with the... That is, don't allow things to be eating you up.
Mm.
Even when you're supposed to flare up, say, you know what? I'm not going to flare up.
Yes.
And there are some people, even if you don't flare up, they are angry again. Don't be angry.
Mm.
Why are you not angry? I choose not to be angry.
Mm.
And you know, to be honest with you, it's no point.
Mm.
Quarreling, fighting,
mm,
going to bed with headache, waking up with headache in the name of marriage. Come on now. It's a new day.
A new day.
I pray, because you see, it is easier said than done.
Yeah, of course.
But I pray God will give everyone watching, grace
yes,
to live in harmony.
Mm.
And God will help us all in Jesus' name.
So this way, that's not our topic, but we are just, you know, as we go on, we digress, whatever the Lord is on our heart, we begin to talk, because we believe that God is touching somebody out there.
Yes.
That God is touching somebody out there. God is touching a relationship. God is touching a marriage. God is touching a heart out there. So that is why you see it's very important for you and your spouse to watch this. Very important, because as we are hearing, each one of you will begin your own.
Pick your own.
You have just thrown it on the floor, on the ground. Now it's left for you to pick your own and make your own adjustment. Mm. And when you pick your own and make your own adjustment, I bet you, I tell you, yes, we enjoy marriage. Marriage is meant to be enjoyed.
It's not meant to be endured
or suffered. If you can really follow the precepts of the Lord, or the God who created marriage and the Bible, I tell you, is the best thing that can happen to a human being. But if it's not handled with care, it's the worst thing that can happen to any individual. So you have to decide which one you want. I know that everybody wants it to be the best. And by God's grace, it shall be the best for everyone in Jesus' name.
Amen. That's why, you know, just relax yourself.
Relax
even in the same place, there will be a miracle.
Yes, sir.
Maybe somebody is preaching back and say, you guys, you are preaching.
Mm.
Do you know the kind of person I'm living with? Mm. Take the matter to God in prayer.
Yes,
God is more than able.
Mm.
In no time, the God of heaven will surely settle you.
Yes,
the two of you, and there shall be peace, there shall be harmony, shall be joy. But you know what? Let it start with you.
Mm.
And we know the King of glory will step in, and there shall be a miracle in Jesus' name.
That's why we always say on this program that marriage is work in progress.
Yes.
The work never ceases or never
keep
stops.
Keep working.
Keep working at it. Now, we have said some things. If you don't see changes yet, keep working at it.
Yes.
One day, your spouse will be touched. One day, there will be a turnaround in that spouse's heart. One day. Look at the way that God touched both Sauls in the Bible. Saul the king. Mm. He had a change of heart. And Saul who became poor, he had a change of heart when he had an encounter. So, you begin to behave the way you're supposed to behave, and your spouse will have that encounter with God, and there will be a transfer. That's why marriage is work in progress.
Mm. But that is why you cannot change your spouse.
You can't, too.
But you can influence your spouse through what you do.
Yes.
For instance,
through words.
You know, some people are very abusive. They come in. Before they open their mouth, they are abusing their husband or they are abusing their wife. Choose not to respond the same way. You think my mouth cannot respond? I will show you today that I have sharp mouth. Mm. No. Do you know every time somebody will do something that is, will I say?
Questionable.
Thank you. I don't want to say stupid. Every time somebody is doing something that is stupid or foolish and you refuse to join, then it makes you the wise one.
Mm.
You're saying, you know what? Even if you don't have to say anything, you know what? I know more than this. I know better.
Mm.
And because I know better, I'm not going to respond the way you are reacting. Because if I respond, there shall be fire on the mountain.
Of course,
and do you know? You won't lose your peace.
Mm.
That's why we pray for every couple out there.
Amen.
The peace from above.
Amen.
May that peace locate you in Jesus' name. The Bible says, may the Lord of peace himself give you peace by all means. God is interested in our peace.
Mm.
And you see, we have to cooperate with God. How do you cooperate with God? By being very patient and being tolerant. You don't have to answer everything. You don't have to react to everything. I'm telling you, you put that into practice, you realize that you have this inner peace.
Yes, yes.
Because inner peace is good, though.
It's good, though.
Then don't let marriage steal your inner peace.
Mm. And may God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And may God uphold us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So for those who are joining us, and in all our discussions are based on Christian principles from the Bible. It's an interactive discussion where we talk about your concerns, your troubles, the issues you may be encountering, and also answer any question that you may have. It's an interactive forum where we discuss together. That's why it's important for you to be making your comments and picking up your comments either on Facebook or YouTube. We're not just downloading on you or dumping it on you. No, it's interactive. That's why you can see people are interacting and making comments to buttress or to put in their own ideas or their own understanding, and then we discuss together. So that's why we call it a forum. And God will bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen. And the Bible reading for today is Matthew 23, verse 3 says, so practice and observe everything they tell you, but do not do what they do, for they do not practice what they preach. That is loaded.
Loaded. So, it is, you know, some people out there is Do what I say.
Don't do not what I do.
And in those days, Christ was referring to the Pharisees and the scribes, because there were people that would tell people, this is what the law says, and yet they are not obeying the law. So he said that practice, Christ was saying that, okay, all what they say, practice and observe it, but don't behave the way they behave, because if you behave the way they behave, you end up in a place where you least expect. So what is the Bible saying there? That, you know what? Observe, practice, I mean, listen to what they are saying. And that is a word for marriages out there. That's what we're going to discuss. Marriage out there. That is, listen to what they are saying, but you see, don't follow in suit of what they are doing.
That is, don't be hypocritical.
That is it. That's the word.
In other words, don't be living one way in the house, mm-hmm. at home, mm-hmm. and then outside there.
There's something else.
Like, say, Angel Gabriel or Sister Mary. No. Our life must be in line with the word of God. Whatever is, that is the way you are living in the house, leave it out there.
Yes, sir.
Do you know if God will put a video, every time somebody will watch, somebody will walk into the church, and what people are doing at home,
It's shown
on projected. A video. Some people will run back home. because as they are coming in, people will say, is this this person? So, we're saying that we have to live. And that's why Bible says, let this mind be in you, which was in Christ Jesus. We cannot afford to be having this life that when we are told me something else, when we are out there, when we are out there, we can be very sweet. But when we are in the house,
there's something else.
Tiger, lioness, lion, God forbid. We shouldn't be like that. Do you know, I'm telling you, some people, the way they live in the house, if people out there will see them, and actually this affects preachers too. Preachers, good afternoon, sir. Is it afternoon now?
Anywhere.
Okay.
Afternoon, good, evening, okay. good morning, good night.
Good afternoon, ma. Good evening, sir. Good morning, ma. Good afternoon, sir. Good evening, sir. And do you know this affects preachers a lot? That's why, do you know some people, when they are preaching, their wife will just turn
her face.
Say, is this you preaching or somebody else? And it could be the wife too. While the woman is preaching, the man is saying, are you preaching? Continue. When you lie to these people, finish. That is English, Nigerian English. When you finish lying to these people, let me hear. You know, I'm just talking Nigerian English. When you lie, finish, let me know. That is, when you finish lying to these people, let me know. Because maybe the woman is thinking, is this coming out of your mouth? Hey, mouthpiece of God. We shouldn't be like that. And do you know, preachers, there's a word the Bible used now. To whom much is given,
much
is expected. Or somebody, I don't know your position in church. You are you are elder, you are deacon, you are minister, you are apostle, you are bishop, you are that. And you are still slapping your wife. And you come to church. Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. Hey! I'm sure the spouse will say, they have come.
Carry on.
They have come. Carry on.
Carry go.
Carry. They have come. What are we saying? The Bible says, we should live by example.
It is true. Live by example. That's very important. Live by example. Don't be somebody that when you're out as a spouse and you're talking and being nice, your spouse will be just raising his or her nose on you, unknowingly, or just doing this, or pretending as if they're not hearing what you are saying, right? Because they know you are a great pretender. You know, that is why you see the Lord doesn't like hypocrites. Even the devil himself doesn't like hypocrites. So it's double sided. That's why you see, be what you are. Let what you are be the same in the house and on the outside. The charity begins at home. That's very, very important. You know, some people, they are well dressed. You know, you can use suits or dress to cover every vibe that you practice. Once you're suited up, and you put on perfume and you comb your hair, you are something else. And you know, because you are in suit, you are out there, you try
Hallelujah.
To pretend you pretend to be who you are not. And you people say, that man must be a good husband in the house.
Hallelujah.
Look at the way he's raised up his hands. Look at that woman. That woman must even for her to say hallelujah is very difficult. That means that even at home, she does not see anything. She's a quiet woman. Who told you? And that is what the Bible is saying, that you see, hear what they are saying, but don't do what they are doing. Mm-hmm. If you do what they are doing, that person may end up in hell. May we not end up in hell. Amen. And may God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We bring us the topic.
It says dealing with double standard in your spouse.
Mm.
Dealing with double standards
in your spouse.
In your spouse.
Mm. Double standard, which is this. Yes. Do what I do.
Mm.
I do what I say. But don't, what I do.
Don't do what I do, but
do what I say. So, dealing with double standard in your spouse. Mm. How do you deal with double standard in your spouse? As I said before, your spouse is like a lion in the house.
Mm.
And then when he or she goes out, it's like a lamb in outside there. And they cannot say anything. Even if you say something to him or her, the way would he act so smoothly and so nicely.
Say, well, look, we will soon get
home. And when you get home, you say the same thing, you know what the trouble may be. So, that's what we want to talk about. And then, question, as you know, it's question time. So, please be ready to answer and God will bless us in Jesus' name.
So, please, all our daddies and mommies, all our experienced married people, we know some of you are married 50, 60, 70 years. Please be a part of this. Even if you are just married yesterday, be a part of this discussion. Because you see, everybody must learn. You see, this is our learning curve.
Yes, sir.
You know, funny enough, it's only marriage that you get your certificate before you start the journey.
Yes, sir.
It's only in marriage. That's why, as we are in the marriage, we are learning every day.
Yes,
so please, let's all learn together. Let's share our wealth of experiences. And God will bless us in Jesus' name. Question one says, how do you understand the word double standard? How do you understand the word double standard? Please, everybody, drop in something. How do you understand the word double standard? I will say one word.
Because we need to understand what double standard is before we begin to discuss. We need to understand what it is, and then we can begin to discuss. Because no use discussing when we don't understand what double standard means. Yes, Pastor, sorry.
Just one word. Hypocrisy. And hypocrisy is bad, though.
Hypocrisy. So how do you deal with hypocrisy in your spouse? You can use that word too. So hypocrisy. So,
how do you understand the word?
I don't say that. I'm just saying we can substitute double standard for with hypocrisy. How dealing with hypocrisy in your spouse. So how do you understand the word double standard? When we say double standard, what does it mean? What does it, someone says, living a double life.
Yes, so
living a double life. You know, for example, now in the world, some spouses live a double life because they are spies. And when they are spies, they pretend to their wives or their husband as if they are that innocent man or woman walking in a car, not knowing that they are spies out there and they have set, you understand? So and so, that's like double life. So somebody says that living a double life.
Somebody said fake.
Somebody says
fake life.
Fake life. Somebody says, and when you say fake, not that they are trying, not that they are poor and trying to be rich or rich trying to be poor, but their life is fake in the sense that they are not what they are. They are not what they are. What they are in the house is different from what you see outside.
Yes.
What they are in the house is different from what you see outside. And somebody says two-faced individual. I love that word. Two-faced.
They have a mask. When they are going out, they put on their mask. And when they are in the house, they remove the mask.
So, which is true. So, we can see that people are getting the word double standard. That is, if somebody who is not truthful to themselves, is somebody who is a pretender, is somebody who is an hypocrite, is somebody who is double-minded, double-faced, is somebody who is fake, somebody who is living a double life. And all these things, the Bible does not support it.
Yes, when we say double standard, it means, like I said, hypocrisy.
Yes.
It means somebody that is deceptive.
That is the word, deceptive.
Somebody that is insincere. Somebody that is self-righteous. Even this one says somebody that is fraudulent. You know, somebody can be fraudulent in marriage.
Yes.
Because when they are not being truthful,
yes,
everything is only fake. Fake. When somebody is, don't let me go into grammar now. When somebody is fishy.
Fishy. You know, when you say somebody is fishy.
When somebody is unreliable. Because you cannot predict them.
You can't.
If they say, I'm going to Sainsbury's, it is Tesco they are going to. And so on and so forth.
So may God help us in Jesus' name. And these are the things we want to deal with, that if a spouse exhibits such traces, how do you deal with it? And these are the things we want to discuss today, because some people are in such a dilemma and they don't know how to deal with it. They don't know which way to turn, and it's killing them inside. So, you know, there's nothing as bad as something that it is pressing you and you cannot talk about it, cannot discuss it. You know, it will be eating that individual inside. It will be killing that person bit by bit. May God help us in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Pastor Richard said, say it, man. Speak the grammar.
Speak the grammar. Speak the grammar. So may God help us in Jesus' name. Amen. So I think we now have a rough idea of what double standard is.
Yes.
Dealing with double standard in your spouse. No, so we can go to question two. So question two, I think we have answered some of it, but let's just say, give examples of double standard in a relationship. We need to know, give an example of double standard in a relationship. So how do we see that? When we say relationship, husband and wife, people courting. So what examples can you give when it comes to double standard?
Number one is deceit.
Because
deceit has many cousins and friends.
Friends, cousins,
deceit, nephews, we give birth to every other thing. That's my opinion.
Yes.
When somebody's deceitful, check it out. You know, we've been giving examples of when somebody is, you know, when we're talking, somebody when they're in the church, they are something else. When they are in the house, something else. Because it's all about deceit. Deceiving people with their looks, with the way they talk. But when they are with their spouse, it's a different ballgame. So deceit, I would say, is the grandfather. Deceit is the grandfather of double standard. Because come to think of it, double standard is
hanky panky, play hanky panky.
Yeah.
You're not here, you're not there. Nobody can catch you. You're playing hanky panky.
Never.
Hanky panky. So give an example of that in a relationship. For example, now you are married and you are pretending you are keeping another home somewhere.
Yeah.
Double standard.
No, that one is this advanced. That one is sacrilege.
As somebody would say, the general overseer of them all is that. So may God help us in Jesus' name. So give examples of double standard in a relationship. So we can see that deceit, a man is pretending, or even when people are courting and a man has two girlfriends or two, you understand, and the man is trying to pretend amongst them, or a woman has two boyfriends and trying to pretend amongst them.
A woman having two boyfriends.
They do it now, Pastor.
The woman is sick.
Of course, they do it now. And the woman will pretend and give one time to come, another one time to come. All this is form of double and deceit. May we not be deceitful in Jesus. So, what are examples of double standard in a relationship? You give your example. You've said some.
Let me give a PhD example. One PhD example. You know all these deceit, they are in levels.
Of course.
Levels. True story, oh. Anything I'm telling you is never a fabu.
Pastor, it has true story.
Yes. Yeah, so there was one sister. She's married. And in the marriage, and they've married for quite a while. And she was saying, thank God, my honey pie, my sugar, my coconut, my butter, and my bread, blah, blah, blah. And then one day, one woman came to meet this married woman and said, look, you are finished. I'm sorry for you. Say, what do you mean? He said, every morning, we see your husband pushing buggy. You know, I said, that one is advanced one. It's grandfather liar. Grand deceit. Said, you sit here every morning. We see your husband by the bus stop pushing buggy. The girl said, never. It is. But please, so. And you know, we women, we can fight about everything. Then please, so don't come to me again. Say, you will soon understand. Lo and behold, you know what happened? One day, a letter came in through the post box. And it was addressed to the man. And the woman now opened it. Guess what? It was from Inland Revenue. I think the man and the other woman, concubine, was trying to do child benefits. So obviously the name of the man, so there's no lying in that. Father of the children, two children. The man had been pushing buggy for years and with the wife. And guess what? When the man is going to say, hey, honey baby, honey pie, I am going for night duty. not knowing that the man is going to the other woman's
house.
That you know that one is advanced level. It's PhD in lying and deceit. If you are born again, even if you are not born again, nobody should be living that kind of life. And I tell people, I say, look, if anybody is living like that, payday is coming. Whatever a man sows,
that he will reap. Amen, amen. Somebody says on YouTube, what is good, that is just describing and double standard in relation. What is good for the goose is not good for the gander.
Yes,
that is, I, as a goose, can do this, but you as a gander cannot do this. And that's what we call double standard. May God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You know, a man can tell his wife he can cheat, but you wife cannot cheat. You understand? Even though cheating is not good in any form or in any way. So that's what you see. That is what we call double standard. For example, a good example, if you're not careful, is that a man's family wants to come to your house to have lunch, and the woman is saying,
They can't come.
Okay, the man doesn't say anything. And now the woman's people want to come and you want to insist that they come. And how is that? That's what we call double standard.
Yes, sir.
Or a story I read, whereby, true story I read, whereby this man said he wanted to surprise the wife. And then the wife, he told the wife that, honey, family members are coming. My family members are coming, and then I will give you money. You cook for them. You do this, you do that. And the wife said, okay, I will cook. And who are they? You see them when they are coming. My family members are coming. They are coming. And then, you know, the man gave the woman the food and all that. And said, okay, in 2 days, they will come. When the day came, the man quickly came early to the house and said, what have you cooked? I haven't cooked anything. You know, there's no food in the house. I gave you money. There's no food in the house. And they're coming now. My family members are coming now. And the man now stomped out of the house and he drove off. And guess, lo and behold, the family members came. Who are they? The father, the mother, the brother and sister of the wife came to the house and she was shocked and she called the man. What are you? Where are you? Ah, the man said, I am far away. Ah, because you need to buy something. These people are here. It's my family member. The man said, sorry, I am far away. Well, that's double standard, because she was thinking that, okay, and it can happen either way. You understand? It can happen either way. That's why you see, that's what we call double standard. What is good for the goose is also good for the gander. And that's examples of, when it comes to examples of double standard in a relationship. May God help us in Jesus' name.
Amen. Just to confess what you said, do you know some people? Once their in-laws are coming, they'll be running to the toilet. They have stomachache. They have headache. They are not happy. But as if it's their own people, they are happy.
Ah, they work everything. It shouldn't be.
Do you know, let me tell
that's
you something.
Double standard.
Let me tell you something.
That's double standard.
If as a man or as a woman, you are married, and every time somebody that is related maybe to your wife is coming, that is when you will now go upstairs or you go somewhere. You go and lock yourself up. You don't say, ah, they are downstairs. I am busy. Every time somebody from the other side are coming.
Not other side. Your spouse, other side.
No.
Your in-law.
Your in-law. Or it might not even be in-law. Okay. It could be your spouse friend.
Of course.
Your spouse, whatever. That is just connected with your spouse. That is when you say, hey, I'm coming. That's when you'll be squeezing your face. You'll be marching up and down the house. Something is wrong.
Because
I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry, ma'am. But you know, we have to say the way it is.
Yes, so
something is not right somewhere.
Whereas
if it's your own people, you go all over the place. Honey, they are coming. He shouldn't be like that. What is good for you is good for the man.
Yes,
what is good for the man is good for the woman. Wife. That's why we have to be. And do you know, it's because in life we are never fair. People are
selfish.
Not fair. Thank you. It's all about selfishness. The moment you see your mother-in-law, you are squeezing your face, you are angry, you will double your size. Or the moment you see your mother, no, it's true. Let me say the way it is. Or the moment you see your it could be anybody. You know, some people, they're not, of course, I know we are more hospitable than the, it's not on the same level. But at least, even if you're not hospitable, God teach me, you know, some people don't know how to smile for real. Some people don't smile, they don't joke, they don't laugh. Despite that, at least still try.
Do
you know some people, when you go to their homes, they don't have to tell you leave before you say,
I'm going up.
I was just passing by. I will see you later again. Because of the body language. Even if there's a quarrel between the two of you, before anybody will enter, the moment they enter, change the atmosphere. No, it's true. Even people, when they're angry, they want everybody to know that, hey, angry. Why are you here? Look, I'll be angry. So no human being must enter. It shouldn't be like that. You don't have to put all your laundries out there.
Of course.
Why are we seeing this? So that we can all learn. Let me tell you something. Nobody is perfect.
Nobody's perfect.
But we are moving towards perfection. And may God help us all in Jesus' name.
Somebody gives an example here of double relationship, double standard in the relationship. That when someone gives relationship advice to others, yet they treat their partner wrongly or even cheat on them. I've seen that many times. Some people will call themselves marriage counselors, and when you see them treating their wives or their husband, you'll be shocked.
You'll be crying for the spouse.
Is it this same man or woman that spoke to us or spoke to those people or preached so beautifully about relationship? And that's why I said that. I keep saying it. If you want to do a program on relationship, I don't believe it's one man affair or one woman affair. If you want to do relationship, then bring your husband and
together,
or bring your wife and do it so there can be some balancing. A man can come and tell us cock and bull story about how he treats his wife, and he may treat his wife as anything. So when
when the person is lying, nobody will look and say, I beg stop lying now.
But when they are together, I repeat that again, I keep saying that, relationship forums should be between the husband and wife sitting together and discussing it. There's no way on earth. I'm sorry to say this. Someone who has failed in marriage or relationship is now sitting down and saying, I want to talk about relationship. What do you want to give me?
I'm sorry to say, if somebody is not married yet.
Yes, I want to go.
You have not been to that school. It's like somebody writing a book on parenting. You have not
given birth.
You have never done anything about parenting. You are writing a book. I remember TDJ said, one man said, oh, Pastor. He said the man was just 1 year in marriage. I'm writing a book about parenting. He said, wow, well done. Good luck to you. He said, after 10 years, he saw him and said, oh, how is your book about parenting? The man said, I chuck it aside because it is not what I am thinking.
Of course. Somebody says on YouTube that one spouse can behave poorly, but if the other spouse did the same, it will be war. It is true. It will be war. That is that's double standard. Do what I say, not what I do. You cannot do the same thing I am doing. And three children, so mind this, whereby one spouse will do the same thing the other person is doing, and it causes commotion. Well, when the spouse does it,
I'm gonna pay you back in your own coin.
When the spouse does it to them, they don't like it. That's why talking about double standard, because we need to. Why are we talking about it today? To check our
lives,
our behaviors, our action and reaction to our spouse, that we may correct. Because some people don't even know they are double standard, if I can use that word. And that's why we need to change. May God help us in just people are saying something.
He says they will say, oh, by this time yesterday we had already gone to bed. In other words, we
not
don't
stay
want
you. Of course, you don't want you. And somebody says, is there anything else? So you see, may God help us in the name of Jesus. Somebody said there's always an emergency situation. You need to go and handle it as if you don't want anybody, which is true. You can say things, but you see, we always need to be very welcoming. Once you are married, you see, there was somebody that came and said that, okay, I want to marry, this is a lady's talking, I want to marry a man who has no mother. And I asked her that when you give birth to a boy, do you want to die before the boy is get married? No. See, that's what you are saying.
People are just wicked.
That is double standard. You want to marry somebody that hasn't got a mother. Yet, you as a mother, you have a son. You want to be there when your son is married. So why are you wishing somebody else evil? That's what we call double standard. What you cannot take, don't give it to somebody else. In some manner, that's what double standard is. What you cannot take and accept, don't give it to somebody else, or don't give it to somebody else, or don't lure somebody else into it. May God help us.
Okay, and this actually brought me to this idea of even as a woman or as a man, you know, now by the grace of God, when you're in your 50s, there'll be grandchildren, there'll be in-laws. Don't even practice double standard even with your daughter-in-law, with your son-in-law. Your daughter-in-law is your daughter. Your son-in-law is your son. Don't say, I'm not his mother. I'm not her mother. her mother, let her go and find her own mother. And then you'll be treating her in a very bad way. We shouldn't be like that. Most if we say we are Christians, may God help all of us in Jesus' name.
Amen, amen, amen. May God help us. What's Father saying? Let me embrace more on that. What's Father saying? That you have a son and a married, he's married now. I know you marry, you have a son, you have married a girl, and you have a girl also. So if the girl now works with you, and maybe doesn't take, that's an example, doesn't take your bag, you begin to complain and moan, or doesn't help
you. No, there's a gun.
No, okay, I'm looking for an example of the girl. This okay, you are talking to the to your daughter-in-law, and maybe she don't hear you, and say she's ignoring you. And then you have a daughter that you are even talking to her, she doesn't even listen to you, you don't say anything. But it's the daughter-in-law that you wage war on, that is double standard. That's double standard. What are you saying? What is good for the goose is good for the gander. What you do for your daughter-in-law, can you do the same thing for your daughter? If the answer is no, then that's double standard. So try and balance. Your daughter-in-law is a daughter too to somebody else. Mm-hmm. And you have a daughter too who will marry and marry into another family.
That is it.
That is why you see we need to be good. So that you see what goes around comes around, whatever they say, you understand? So that's why you see be good. As an individual, don't practice double standard. Because double standard can be in many ways.
Yes.
You need to be very, very careful.
That's why it's good to be straight.
Hmm.
Do unto others
as you wish,
what you want you wish others what? To do
unto you. You.
You know, the Bible says God cannot be mocked. Whatever a man sows, that is what he will reap. I'm telling you. That's why whoever will come your way, treat them nicely.
Treat them nicely.
You know, some people, when they see A, they will treat A one kind. When they see B, they will treat B another way.
Yes.
No! Let this mind be in you, which was in Christ Jesus. And this, like somebody said, do what Jesus will do. And you see, you know, now we are actually expanding the thing now.
Yes, sir.
It's not just in marriage,
yes, sir.
To your neighbors, and people in the church, people at work. You know, people will say, hey, everybody's fighting me. Nobody likes me. How is your own attitude?
That is it, too. Check yourself.
Everybody is fighting me.
Yes, sir.
Nobody likes me. Everybody hates me. You yourself, do you like anybody? If anybody will hate, then they too will be hated. If you love, then you will be loved.
Of course.
Because many times we want, you see, and because it's because we are selfish people as human beings.
We want people to be good to us.
But we don't want to be good to
them. You are nasty to them.
It's like now, if I see a baby, normally I don't really carry babies, especially when they are heavy ones. I just from afar. But if a baby is so, you're looking at the baby. The baby is smiling. By the time you are stretching your hand, you will not even know.
Yes,
because the baby is already smiling. But if you see a baby, I don't even want to carry you too. So you know what? We need to be good. Everybody, please stop it out. We need to be good. Because you'll be surprised. What? Because it's good. Like somebody will say now, it is easy to see somebody else's
back.
To see the back of the head.
Yes.
It's so easy. You see, what we are doing today is like a mirror. We are mirroring
ourselves,
saying, you know what? What am I doing to people? What I'm doing to people? Do I want to be treated
the
that
same way?
May God help us.
May God help us and deliver us in Jesus' name. And may God uphold us. So, dealing with double standard in your spouse. Not only in your spouse, even in yourself also. You know, we need to look at ourselves, not only your spouse, look at yourself and make sure you are not someone who is walking in double standard.
Yes.
If you are not a man or a woman of do what I say, but not what I do. Very, very, and it's very common in houses, things we do and things we talk, things we say, our behavior, you understand? So may God help us in the name of Jesus. May God uphold us in the name of Jesus. Do unto others as you wish others to do unto you.
Thank you for responding. Everyone, thank you, you are blessed.
On both YouTube and Facebook, you can see you. God bless you. Thank you very much. God will bless, increase, and prosper you. Let's move on. So we're talking about double standard,
yes,
in marriage, because it is there.
It is a destroyer of marriage.
It is there.
If you go and see any marriage that is broken down today, it's because there are double standards.
Double standard.
People are living two lives.
They are not what they are on the inside. When the society begins at home, there are one thing at home and another thing on the outside. So may God help us in Jesus.
Amen.
That's why we need to deal with this double standard in ourselves. Not even dealing with your spouse alone, but even in yourself also. Because if it's there, you need to be truthful and deal with it so that you can. Because many times, the way you are treating your spouse, we like your spouse to treat you the same way.
That is just it.
If you can answer that, the way you are treating your spouse now, what you said to your spouse the last time, how you behaved to her or him the last time.
Do you want you to go through the same thing?
Do you want your spouse to deal with you the same way? Mm-hmm. For the measure you give is the measure you get. That's what the Bible said. The measure you give,
and it will come back to you. Good measure, press down, shake it together, running over, shall men give unto your bosom. For the same way you give, that's the same way.
He made that back to you.
That is times seven.
That's you see, times seven. That is the Bible. Mm. So what you are doing to your spouse, what you are doing to her, to him, would you love your spouse to do the same
thing
to you?
You
are a man or a woman that's always shout down on your spouse.
Mm.
Would you want your spouse to shout down on you? That is the question. Mm. You are the type of spouse that doesn't accept any idea from your spouse. Would you want your spouse not to accept or acknowledge ideas from you too? You know, if we can, as Christians, look in our spouses, look at our say that, okay, what I want to say, what I want to do, the action I want to take.
Yes.
Would I be happy if my spouse does the same thing to me? Then you will know what to do. Very important.
No, to be honest.
Very, very important.
Do you know?
Very important.
Do you know, in marriages today,
mm.
there's so much deceit
mm.
that it is appalling. That's why when people, when they will go for marriage counseling, as one is lying, the other one is lying.
Mm.
That it will take wisdom, it will take the sign of spirit to pick it up. That's why I keep saying, so people don't have any business with marriage counseling.
Of course, so, of course.
Once they have the vendetta, or they have something against one of the spouses, whether the other one is lying through their teeth so they can't see it, because they themselves, they are not truthful.
They themselves,
they are living a double life. Mm. That's why I tell people, I say, look, if you know you have not been called into marriage counseling, don't even try it, oh.
Mm.
Because the Bible says, whatever we do, God will judge us.
Of course. So may God help us. Just want to make comments on Pastor Chris. God bless you. Thank you, Mommy. How a woman in charge of church is complaining of people in the church and not liking her. Mm, that's another case entirely on its own. The woman also needs to behave. We don't know the story, but I believe that any woman or man of God needs to behave appropriately to their members. And I believe...
Can I say this? You know, by grace, yes, I'm a pastor's wife and I'm a pastor. I've realized that. Because and I noticed that many women, and which is the less said, which is many women are going through issues that
of course,
people
church.
Will not just like the pastor's wife. They don't like female pastor, but they like the Elijah of our time.
Mm.
The only prophet in town. The only apostle in town. The only bishop in town. But when they see mommy pastor, saying, what she doing here now? Even some people are even wishing her dead. No, it's true.
I know. But
do you know my advice for women? I say, when they will start their, I call it nonsense. When they start their nonsense, don't even see them.
Mm.
Be pursuing God. Be running after God. Of course, every woman of God, when they will start, it's all that, I don't know why, and it's always the women that will be against the woman of God.
Mm.
Don't mind them. I'm telling you, face your God, face your Jesus.
Yes,
after a while, they will not have a choice. And they say, we love you by fire, by force. So, because your own behavior, your own anointing, because as they are misbehaving, as they are doing you bad, you are doing them good. You are praying for them. One day, there will be a change of heart. But you know the problem of our world today? Many women out there, and if I'm wrong, correct me, many women of God out there, when church members are waging war against them, they too, they are waging war against church members.
Mm.
Do you have time for that?
Mm.
Come on now. You don't have to. Like what Pastor said, he says, at least somebody said, don't look at your critics. Celebrate your fans. It doesn't matter.
Of course.
There'll be one human being that will say, I love this woman.
Of course.
I like her face. Mm. I like the way she talks. Even if there are other people that say, I don't like her, with time, they will not have a choice. Because if God loves you, who has the audacity to say, I don't like her?
Mm.
You know, some people, they are so happy when that the pastor is not in good terms with the wife. They are very happy.
Mm.
Hey, you see them, you see? They'll be blushing. And then they'll be coming to the pastor. And pastor. And if the woman will even start, what's she doing now?
Mm.
To be honest with you, don't mind them. Of course, we all went through that in the beginning. And I would say it's jealousy. They see you as a threat. They are jealous. But with time, I'm telling you, they will not have a chance to say, God has called this man. You better just leave her. Mm. If you don't want to hit your head against the rock. And that's why I tell women, stop fighting for yourself.
Mm.
You know, some people, they will use all their lives to fight church members. Who called you as a woman? No, that's another topic entirely. Who called you? Is it the church members? I beg. Don't mind anybody.
May God help us. And I believe that many church members are also guilty. And I'll give you examples of what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Many church members are guilty of double standard towards husband and wife.
That's yes.
Why I believe that pastors who are husband and wife must know themselves very well, because what people say can split and cause commotion in a marriage, even in pastor's marriage. For example, somebody wants to give a testimony and comes to church, or somebody wants to say, I've seen in many instances that they will invite either a guest minister or a guest minister who is a woman, or a guest minister who is a singer, or even a man, and they will come, oh, thank God for this church. Thank God for our daddy. God has blessed our daddy. Thank God, daddy, for giving me this opportunity to come and sing and this and that. And the wife will be sitting next to the husband as pastor, and they will not even acknowledge
her
presence or anything that she has done, as if the man himself can get the church to where it is without the woman's help or prayer. Even if the woman is not doing anything in church, you know, behind the scenes,
she's
praying and she's working.
So people should leave pastor's wife alone.
Making things to work. We need to know. And that's double standard. And you see, if the woman is not careful,
she cannot
handle it, she will quarrel with the husband. You see that? Church members, see that person invited. Look at what they are doing or saying. Women need to also overlook that. Because
you have to overlook people things.
Who are used, that was a double standard is all around, who are used to this double standard. Maybe they are doing it knowingly or unknowingly, but I'm sorry to say, it is women that are doing it to women.
Mm.
Women to women. And that's, what am I saying is that, when you go to a place, you are a guest, make sure to acknowledge the man and the woman together, not just the man. People say, Elijah for our time. Daddy is a good daddy. Oh, he's a good pastor. And the mommy is sitting next to the wife is sitting next. And
no, you don't even nobody.
And you don't even acknowledge at all. I believe that in that area, we need to change, and may God help us. That's part of double standard we're talking about.
Some people are causing problems in marriages.
The people are not mature, of course.
Pastor, even the worst one is, when a woman, they follow the husband to go and preach somewhere.
Of course.
And they will now say, woman, sorry, it is not you. They won't say it, but the action is, we have not invited you. You go and sit somewhere. Go and sit at the back. And then now, they are larger of our time. And yet, you are preaching what God has joined together. Let nothing put asunder. And because the man is a man, you now say, sir, sit here. You now go and drop the woman somewhere in the name of but she's a woman now. Who is she? It is the man that God has called. Stop spoiling people's homes. They said Baba Adeboye did something many years ago. He said it with his own mouth. He went to preach somewhere many years ago, and they now gave Baba one chair.
And then they said
Mama should sit somewhere. The man said, oh, thank you. He said, Mommy, sit on that chair. Don't worry, I will stand. Because
quickly they want to,
of course, because people think, well, it's just the wife now. Mm. And you know, it might not be in the church, it could be anywhere. Treat people rightly. You know, now we expand, we're expanding it.
Yes,
that's why I beg you, servant of God. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
You know,
I have to salute them. Mm. Funny enough, women hardly do that to their husbands, That when, I'm not sorry. Let's say the way it is. You will see some men. Now we are going everywhere now. Mm. The way they treat their wives in church.
Mm, it's very appalling.
They treat her as a piece of rack.
I've been to many places. I traveled enough. Whereby, when I'm in the church to minister, I'll be asking the man of God,
Where is your wife?
You'll be pointing somewhere. And you know, when you travel or when you go to places, you cannot intervene or talk about some things because you'll be, but I begin to wonder, you are the pastor, you are here, you have a big chair seated, and your guest is sitting next to you, and your wife
has disappeared
somewhere, not even having a chair or seat next to you. What are you telling the church? What are you transmitting to the church? And even it works some ways. I've seen where women are the pastor, and when there's a guest in the church, the man will go and sit somewhere else, and they put the guest beside the woman pastor, and the man will have to go and look for a place to sit. All these things, they
that
are
one
wrong.
Is not, that That's, one is not very common.
But it happens, pastor.
I know.
And these are all doubles. We are all human beings. We have feelings. How would you feel for such a thing to happen to
for you?
For
you to be treated that way.
Your wife is invited to a place, and you as a husband, you followed her to support. And they tell you, wife, sit down there. Man, go and sit down at the back. It doesn't matter.
Why you know, they hardly do that.
I'm giving an example that how would you feel if it happens to you? I'm trying to put it back.
Yeah, balance
double it. So balance that. How would you? You will not feel happy or okay. You will tell your wife, I will never follow you out there. That's the way they will treat me. So if you as a man, you are feeling that way, how do you feel your wife is feeling? So that is balancing. This is all double standard. You know, you're talking about marriage now, about society, about church, about all this, because you say this is a Christian program, and may God help us with Jesus. Let's read this before another one. This one.
Okay. Yes. It says, in like manner, when giving our presents or gifts as a family, for instance, during festive seasons, maybe wife wants her family to be given cow, and for the husband's family, it is okay to be given chicken. So unfair.
Of course.
Double standard to the core. And it's the truth. So. Oh, my mother needs money. My father needs money. But my father-in-law and my mother-in-law, they don't need money. Come on now. Let's be fair.
Let's be realistic.
Fairness. Fairness. May God help us in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. We're talking about double standard. You know, this program, this topic is very wide. We didn't even know you would go as wide as it's going now. But you see, in every aspect of your life, be fair. That is the word. In every aspect of your life, be fair. Somebody is saying on YouTube, Augustina, thank you very much. Thanks, Pastor Mommy, and God bless you, Pastor and Mommy. So God bless you too. I believe
fairness.
That the fairness is very important in all what you do. In a nutshell, what you don't want people to do to you, don't do to them. That's a nutshell. That's what double standard is. What you don't want people to do to you, don't do to them. And may God help us in Jesus' name.
As I want to beg everyone watching today, treat that mommy. I know I'm from African background. We call them mommy pastor. Or pastor, missus, or reverend, whatever. Treat them well. Treat them. You'll be surprised how much commotion people are causing
in marriages.
From church. Especially from church. Treat them well. And that is the honest truth. Examine yourself today. How are you? Because it could be the other way around too. It could be the other way around too. We don't want to see that the pastor, we only want to see mommy pastor. No, treat them equally. Because every time people are doing that, they are causing friction in the home. And I think I think it's common with
the women bear more of the brunt than men. That's
yes, you see, it's more common that you see they will make the woman feel worthless, feel useless. Feel to be nothing. We shouldn't do that. Even if she cannot say one prayer, at least she's the one taking care of that Elijah.
That
the Elijah
have,
of our
course.
Time, the prophet of our time, the only servant of God, the only one with the fiery mouth, the only one with the biggest cap. And you will see the wife, you treat her like a piece of rag. That is what we call deceit. Deceit. Because if truly, you love that man, the wife too,
of course, so you love
will
her.
Be your angel. And people don't know that every time you are mistreating a woman of God, don't let me say what I want to say.
Let go help us just there. I've seen instances whereby they want to buy things like Christmas or something for their pastors, and they will buy something big for the man.
The Elijah of our time.
Let's just buy something small.
Help the Primark.
And give it, and give it to her.
Go and buy her bedroom
what
slippers.
What does she do? No, we need to balance.
Yes.
Double standard. We need to balance. Because even though I said the woman may not be active in the church, but I believe that for you as a church member to enjoy the man of God, that is from the work of the woman. Because if the woman is saying that, look, you're not going to church today, no matter what, I will lock the door. They may find a fire, but the man may not go. Or he say, okay, I'll not give you peace of mind. The man will not be able to hear from God. Because maybe as they are coming to church, the woman is fighting and breaking and saying things, and the man is not focused. How can he hear from God? So also, the woman has a role to appreciate the woman, appreciate the man. What am I saying?
Let me be wrong.
Balance the appreciation. That's what I'm saying. Balance the appreciation. And also, husband and wife balance it, and may God help us in Jesus'
name. Amen. Let me be wrong now. You think if that's your Elijah of our time, the only prophet on planet Earth, if there is no wife, you think all of you will rest in the church? If a man of God has no wife, and is of my table, he's no wife, you think the man can hear properly from God? If guys, I'm talking now, I'm being real now. If guys not taking, as he's looking at sister Janne Koko, we'll be looking at the skirt of sister. See, I don't want to mention any name. That's why I'm forming names. You think if that woman is not satisfying the man, if there's no woman beside the man, you think the man can survive? Men, but it's not good for a man to be alone. So if the man, that's why you see people when they are single, maybe may even not fall upon a man or a woman of God. When something, God forbid, when anything will happen, what will happen? Within few years, man, the man will go and marry again. Because there is no way, that's the way God created man. Unless those who are eunuchs or those who are fathers. Even the fathers do, even though they are called fathers.
May God help us.
So that's why. Treat that woman. That you are seeing that Elijah of our time, the only prophet in town, the only pastor in town, the only bishop in town, the only seasoned pastor, is because there's one woman at home
taking care of him.
So please leave those women alone. Leave women of God alone. You know, some people, you'll be surprised how many people are guilty of this. What I'm going to say now.
Of course now.
The moment they finish eating, they will now use the pastor Mrs. as toothpick. Did you see her today? See her, see. See how she was walking like a dog. I said, I thought I was the only one that saw that is double standard. And yet, we will not talk about the man like that. May God help us. May God deliver people. May God change people's mouth in Jesus' name.
May God help us in Jesus' name. What I still don't understand, maybe somebody can explain to me. What I still understand is that, why is it that it is women that wage war against women?
Because they are the most in church.
At work, in church, in family. Now, if a woman marries, if a man marries a woman, a man marries and a wife, it is the sister of the man and the mother of the man that if they begin to wage war against the wife. And yet they are women. Except some men who are, you hardly see the man or the brother
waging war. Strange men.
Waging war against the woman. I don't know why women are the one, even in church, it is women who are waging war against women. Say, I cannot take this anymore. Let's see how we can do this. Let's see how we can riot. Let's see how we can oppose. Let's see how we can talk. And it's women. So I don't know if anybody can explain to me why it is women who are waging war against women. In church, in society, in family, anywhere. And these same women who are waging war against their sister-in-law, who are waging war against their sister-in-law, and when they marry, they will not take the nonsense they are expecting their sister-in-law, who is married to their brother, to take. That's why I don't, and that's what we call double standard. You see, let's treat. I can just pray this prayer that the same way, it's not, I'm not saying, I'm not praying it to, the same way you have treated your sister-in-law, who is your brother's wife. May they treat you the same way.
Many people will not say amen.
They say it's a curse. Why is it a curse? If you know you've treated your sister-in-law, who is the wife of your husband, of your brother, very well, then you should be able to say amen.
Amen.
But many people know that they have not done that. And they know that inside them, they are not fair enough to. Because let me tell you, you have a brother and you are the sister to the brother. You cannot marry your brother. Your brother has to go and look for a woman out there and bring her into the house. So you cannot, no matter, mothers, you cannot marry your son. Sisters, you cannot marry your brother. No matter how much you love your brother, no matter how much you love your, no matter.
Fire.
No matter how much you love your brother or no matter how much you love your son, you cannot marry them. So accept the woman he brings as his wife and let him live in peace. Let the woman live in peace. There's no use when the husband will say, my mother is coming, my sister is coming, and the woman is having a heart attack. That means that there's something wrong. But when the husband tells the wife that my mother is coming, my sister is coming, the wife should be happier. When are they coming? When they come. That means that they are well treated. So may God help us. That's food for thought for somebody out there. May God help us in Jesus' name.
That's what I do unto others. It's what you want others to do
unto you. That is it. That is life. That is how life is. So may God help us. May God deliver us. We're going to continue this topic tomorrow because we don't know. We do not know that it's going to be. Next Sunday, by God's grace. We're not going to be this wide and going to go wider and wider and wider. But may God help. I believe
we will dig deeper.
Men are too busy for jealousy or gossip. Okay, it is well.
Yes, so.
Men don't have time for that.
Some men are wearing, but they presented a few.
So that's why may God help us in Jesus' name. You are a woman. Please let me beg you. Don't wage war against your sister-in-law. Whether you're older than her or younger than her. Don't wage war.
Don't.
You two will get married. Some of you are even in your husband's house.
And you have children.
Would you wish that? And you also, mothers, what you did not take from your own mother-in-law. You're expecting your daughter-in-law to take it from you. They will not. It will not happen. That's why treat other. Remember in those days, when that mama will call you, call mama. Who is your mother-in-law? And the way you behave and that. And now, you are seeing a sign when you go to your son's house that they're doing you the same and you are annoyed. Don't be annoyed. That's double standard. That's the measure you give is the measure you get. Take. You understand? So, may God help us.
Amen.
This is a food for thought for everyone out there. I repeat again. Please, don't wage war against your sister-in-law. Love her. Cherish her. Your brother loved her. Your brother saw her. I said, this is the only woman I love and I want to marry her and be with her. So love the woman the way your brother loves her and there will be peace because one day you two will become a wife. One day you become a sister-in-law to a somebody. You become a daughter-in-law to somebody. So be careful the way you treat others. May God help us.
And then I believe if truly you are born again, you are a child of God. Let this man be in you.
Which was in Christ Jesus.
Bible says, be ye perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. Yes, in other words, do what Jesus will do. The Bible says, imitate me as I'm of Christ Jesus. In other words, do you know some people, their daughter-in-law, their son-in-law will never follow them to church because of their behavior.
Yes, so that's another thing.
And some people, their husband will never follow them to church, or their wife will never follow them to church. Say, you follow you to church? You want me to be like you? Because the character is not in line what they are seeing. I'm trying to say, some people's character is worse than unbelievers' character.
I thought I would say, I know a true story. True story, no true story.
No, Fabu!
A true story of somebody that married a man and they were living happily until the mother of the man came and scattered the whole thing. For about 3, 4 years or 5 years, the woman did not enjoy the husband. Even there was a time the woman had to pack out of the house. And this woman I'm talking about is a senior deaconess in a big church. I don't want to mention the church.
I know that story.
A big church. You know, after a while, the man said, okay, mother, be going. And you know, the mother went away. The wife came back. Now they're living happily after. The mother said, I want to come. But the man said, don't come again. Because the man has realized
what went wrong.
And now they are living happily ever after. So you see, the mother was the one. Because you mothers, you cannot marry your son.
Mm-mm.
It's an abomination.
Oh, sister-in-law.
You cannot marry your son. So leave your son alone with his wife. Let him enjoy his wife that God has given to him. You cannot choose for him. He has chosen himself. That's why marriage is what we choose ourselves. It is you, the man, that went, I saw this woman. I like her. And he brought her. And said, will you marry me? And she married you. So don't let anyone dissuade you, man. Either your mother-in-law or your sister-in-law, or your auntie, or whatever. Don't let your mother or your sister dissuade you. Love the wife that God has given to you.
Another advanced story. True story. A lady was married, and they were happy, until the sister of the husband.
As it came.
That is the sister-in-law. A big sister-in-law, maybe
senior, to the man.
Yes,
came.
And they said, you are leaving this house, so told the girl.
To the girl.
The woman. You are leaving, true story. You are leaving, you are leaving. You know what they did? They encouraged the man. They helped the man. to pack everything belonging in the house. And they left the woman in another country. They left the woman in an empty... True story.
Jesus.
They left the woman in an empty house. They say, Neva, let her stay.
Let her stay there.
If she doesn't want to go. If hunger and the woman hasn't got a job, they left her in that house. And yet, this big sister I'm talking about, she's well-respected person in the ministry. That the moment she walk in, hey, our mommy, and yet, she's a wicked mommy.
You want to scatter somebody else's marriage.
That was how the marriage collapsed.
You see, may God help us in Jesus' name. You know, we are supposed to be repairers of things, not destroyers of things. Many people are destroying minds, and with the words of your mouth, with your action, with your reaction, with everything you are doing and saying. You know, all these things, words are like pin, like nails. They go in. Some words pierce the heart. And when these words comes out, you know, words are like an egg, Humpty Dumpty, that fell, and the soldiers could not put Humpty Dumpty together again. When words come out, you cannot withdraw your word because it would have done the harm and the damage that word was sent for. That's why you see, watch what you say. Actually, when it comes to in-laws, I say again, you sister of that man, you mother of that man, you cannot marry your son,
never.
Cannot marry your brother. That's an abomination. No. Your brother has to go out there and get a woman and bring the woman home. That's how it works. And you, if you truly love your brother, if you love your son, what would you do? You will love the woman he loves, not wage war against the woman that he loves. When you wage war against the woman he loves, you are causing a dilemma and friction and problem in the marriage. That the man will also, if it's not a man who is strong, will be confused. So men are strong. And you say, mommy, enough is enough. Leave it like that. This woman I love. Let me be with her. No problem. So your men can put their foot down. Even to the sister. You're not careful. Say, sister, please leave my house. Don't come and scatter my house. You know? But not every man will be able to say
it's
that.
He's bold enough
to say that. So may God help us in Jesus' name.
Pastor, people must realize that the world is changing. It's true. You know, you were saying that, somebody will complain. My daughter-in-law is not carrying my bag. Those days are gone.
Of course, I'm not saying, I'm not for
example. No, I'm just saying that. Okay, like now, you know, we women of nowadays, we are different in one way. Even if you want to carry my bag, I will tell you, it's part of my dressing. Mm. Those days are gone when your daughter-in-law is your slave.
Of course, so.
She's your daughter. That son is your son. Mm. So love them equally. Because I don't know why people prepare other people.
I know, and their own
children. If you want peace of mind, you want to enjoy your life, I'm telling you, treat that girl. You know, we're talking about marriages now.
Mm.
But you see, there's no way you talk about double standard
that will not
bring in those things. Treat them well.
Treat them well.
Treat them well. We are begging you. That's why. Stop thinking about 1902. You know, in those days, like we are from the Yoruba culture, when you see your in-law, what do? You will kneel down, the two knees must be on the floor. Those days are gone, no. Look at her. See the way she's greeting me. She even wants to greet me. You better accept the greeting. At least she's greeting you. And the way she's bending, she's not bending enough. Really? You want her to... I'm not saying race culture. But if somebody is raised in this part of the world, don't expect them to behave like somebody that was raised in the village. You see, that's where problems are coming in. That's why. Be tolerant. Tolerate people. What about if your wife, your children, will now go and marry people from this Western world? For real. What are you going to do?
You go help us. Somebody says, Pastor Chris says on YouTube, thank you, sir and mommy, for the issues of family interfering. The issues of family interfering in their children's marriage is actually causing lots of problems. It is true. It's causing lot of problems. And when they begin to interfere, you know, the person who is involved and the other party, they are so confused. And may God help us in the name of Jesus. May God uphold us in Jesus. Yes.
Amen. I like this. So it says, wait, 1 minute. It says, may we not be wicked mommies or daddies. Some people are wicked.
Yes, so they are.
And may we not encounter them in Jesus' name. Amen. And our children will not encounter them in Jesus' name.
May God help us in the name of Jesus. And may God uphold us. Because there are some families who are wicked. I'm telling you.
Jehovah.
They are very, 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 very
my
wicked.
My children, they will not enter into wicked family.
They will not enter
into wicked family. And I will not be wicked. We will not be wicked.
In Jesus' name. Amen. you know, we need to love. So in conclusion,
yes,
love your neighbor as yourself.
Finally, my brethren,
don't see your in-law as in-law. See them as your own children.
In love.
In love. See them as your family members. See them as part and parcel of you. Because the Bible said that the two shall become one. So if your son marries, is your son, see that woman as your son. See a woman. And what you tolerate with your daughter. Tolerate, that's the problem. What a mother would tolerate with her daughter.
Is it, for
the she will not accept half of it from this daughter-in-law.
Is it not in our world of today?
And that's what is happening in our world of today. What will not tolerate? So may God help us. I'm just speaking for example. A good example is kneeling down. How many mothers, how many of your own daughters kneel down to you to greet you? No,
I beg.
But it is
that's,
when you have.
I'm saying,
I'm just using an example. When you now have daughter-in-law.
See how she's greeting me.
That's when you begin to complain.
She's not greeting me well.
The way your daughter is also treating you. May God help us in the name of Jesus. You know, may God uphold us and may God guide us and keep us in Jesus' name. Amen.
You know, we can go on and on. God, this topic is very wide.
So may God help us in Jesus' name. Be good, and God will give us the grace.
What are you going to do?
May God help us in Jesus' name. And may God uphold us in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. When you have them in your stock, when I say them in stock, then you'll be praying. And avoidance is the best way, because if you have a family, let me tell you, if you have a family that's always troublesome, avoid. If they want to come, I'm not saying don't let them come, but try.
Because we know some families are troublemakers.
Just avoid.
They like fighting.
You know, they like fighting. So avoid any confrontation.
Defend your wife.
Yes. Avoid.
Defend your husband.
So that is it. That is the same thing. And may God help us and uphold us in the name of Jesus. Let us end there because our time has gone. We'd like to thank everyone. We'll continue this next week. So invite as many people as possible. We have been blessed. Invite as many people as possible and God will help us. Just one prayer point. The Lord, touch my life.
That's what I'm thinking.
Starts with us.
Touch me, Father.
Touch my life.
Touch me, Father.
Don't let me be given to double standard. That is just in a nutshell.
Yes.
Touch my life. Don't let me exhibit any traits
of double
standard. Anywhere I go to, let me give the same name.
Father, in the name of Jesus, King of glory, you are the mighty God. Let this mind be perfect in Christ. Lord, I ask for more of you, oh God. Touch my life, touch my husband, touch my children, oh God. Let us be Christ-like in everything that we do. Let us be good to people, oh God. Anything that is not good in our lives, fire of God. Hey, Holy Ghost, fire, consume it right now. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Father, we bless your name, we worship you, we adore you. Thank you, oh God, because Lord, for your word today.
Yes, sir.
Lord, in any way we are falling below expectation, let the blood of Jesus cleanse everyone.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, we all ask for a new start today.
Yes, Lord.
The grace, oh God, to do your will, to please you.
Yes, Lord.
To be like our Father who is in heaven. May God give it to everyone in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And any marriage that is shaking, let the anointing of God touch it right now in the name of Jesus. And every marriage that is sweet, it will continue to be sweet in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And all the single people who are saying, Lord, I want to be married, like Sotayaba, we decree, we declare your spouse will locate you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not get into the wrong home in the name
Amen.
Of Jesus. And it shall be well with all Amen. Of us. And the manifest of the Lamb, none of us will miss it.
Amen.
Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen, 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 amen. Jesus, may God help us in Jesus' name. Thank you for joining us. Thank you, Pastor Chris. Thank you, Pastor Chichi.
Pastor Mike
and other men and women of God, thank you very much. We appreciate you. God will honor, bless, increase, and prosper you. Thanks for your comments.
Yes,
thanks for everything, because you know you are the one that makes this program keep us going. You know, it's almost 9:30. We didn't even realize because you are making comments and you are supporting. So we appreciate all your support, all your comments on both Facebook and YouTube. God will bless, increase, and prosper you. Don't forget that we air this program. We put that on every Sunday at 8 p.m. So by the grace of God, Pastor myself, if Christ does not come, if he tarries, we'll be back here 8 o'clock by the grace of God next Sunday for a continuation of this topic, dealing with double standard in your spouse and even in yourself. So may God help us in Jesus' name.
God bless you. Thank you. And please remain rapturable.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye and bye-bye and bye-bye. Bye.